I finally think I found out who the Rooster is, Pulcinella. And it all makes sense now. Him being ranked really high and then being ranked by strength, his mysterious identity, his old man demeanor, it all makes sense. So let's go over it. Really quickly, we don't really know anything about the Rooster other than his rank and title. He's the fifth Harbinger, he's the mayor of Shesnaya. He obviously deals with a lot of the logistics and political landscape of Shesnaya. And he was shown in the trailer, the Teyvat trailer, on that throne representing Shesnaya when Dainsleif talks about the rebellion of the Saritsa. That was actually Pulcinella. And once I finally realized who I think he might be, it all made sense. Because Child says that they're all ranked by strength. Now, obviously, we all assume that Pulcinella was more of a political crime boss, like the Penguin or the Joker type guy. He's like Genshin's evil politician, and his power, quote-unquote, is more political. Which, you can have power through control, manipulation, and being cunning, but Child specifically says strength. He uses the word strength. And if you take that exactly how he's saying it, then that means that the Rooster is stronger than the Balladeer and everyone past him. Sandrone, the Crimson Witch of Flames, you name it. And he's ranked pretty high. He's number 5, so he's literally strong despite his appearance. He plays a big political part in Shesnaya, and because he was shown in the trailer, that means he's going to be a main Harbinger slash character in the Archon quest for the Cryo region, Shesnaya. And we know for the most part, the Harbingers are all pretty ancient, old, powerful beings all across Teyvat for the most part. So all of that taken into consideration, he's a strong individual that's probably fairly old. The Harbingers are all very powerful in their own right. He plays a very political and integral role in the politics and just the foundation of Shesnaya running the nation. He's the mayor of Shesnaya and he controls the military role in the nation, running that nation. And he does not seem like the type of guy that we're going to see outside of Shesnaya. I don't think we're going to run into him in Natlin or something like that. And it's pretty well guaranteed at this point he's going to be the main Harbinger of Shesnaya because he was shown in the trailer. And each character that was shown in that trailer ends up being an integral character for that nation's Archon quest. And all of the Harbingers seem to be tied to what happened with Khonria in some way, whether direct or indirect. And the Harbingers, for the most part, their interests align with the Saritsa in overthrowing the Heavenly Principles, getting back to the old world, and their big rebellion, like in the trailer. As they're showing Pulcinella in that trailer, Dainsleif's talking about the rebellion coming at last.
Her followers hope only to be on her side when the day of her rebellion against the divine comes at last.
This all makes so much sense when you think about it, and I do believe Pulcinella does actually agree with the Saritsa and what she's doing. Some of the Harbingers might not. Some of the Harbingers might actually be using the Fatui or the organization to benefit their own means selfishly, but I don't believe the Rooster to be one of them. And that's another thing. The Rooster. His name kind of gives it away as well. And not only being heavily speculated and hinted at, but leaked as well that he's going to have cryo vision or powers. It's so obvious. The role that he plays in Shesnaya is very similar to another character we've seen already, very recently. And if the music in the background hasn't already told you where I'm going with this, well, let's just say the song that's playing in the background is called Dragon Roost Island. Get it? Because he's the Rooster, and he's a dragon, and dragons roost because he's the Cryo Dragon Sovereign? Ha! Sorry, that's a pretty terrible joke, but that's what I'm trying to say. I believe the Rooster to be the Cryo Dragon Sovereign, and that he plays a similar role in Shesnaya that Nouvellet does in Fontaine. But being that he's probably the original or a very older sovereign, his human-like appearance is a lot older, and he even sort of looks reptilian. Like, you look at his eyes and he kind of has that reptilian look to him. I don't know, he just doesn't look like an ordinary human. And if you think about it, if he's the Cryo Sovereign, everything makes sense. His foreshadowing in the trailer talking about the rebellion, it would make sense if he's sitting on the throne being the Cryo Sovereign, because he's the rightful ruler of the Cryo region of Shesnaya then, if he's a Cryo Sovereign. Dragons have only recently started coming to the spotlight in Genshin in its main story. We didn't know a lot about dragons when this game first dropped, so this trailer, we didn't even know who he was exactly. This made no sense. We just think that he's talking about the Tsaritsa's Rebellion and it just showing an individual in this chair. But if it's the Cryo Sovereign, it makes complete sense because they're the original inhabitants. They were usurped. So the Rebellion, with him in the chair, he probably plays the same role as Nouvellette does in Fontaine, being that he's pretty much running the nation, kind of like Nouvellette is, but for Shesnaya, he controls the military, he's super powerful, he's number 5, he probably has a lot of influence, and he would be part of the main Archon story, hence why they're foreshadowing and showing him in the trailer. If he is the Sovereign and a Harbinger, not to mention it makes sense he'd be a Harbinger and ally himself with the Tsaritsa. Their goals would perfectly align. He wants to overthrow the usurper, and the Tsaritsa is doing just that, so they're probably working together. So Dainsleif foreshadowing this in the trailer makes way more sense if you think the Rooster is the Cryo Sovereign. His name, the Rooster, because dragons actually roost. I know you think of a bird when you think of the Rooster. It's a subtle hint towards him being the Cryo Sovereign as well. Not to mention his mysterious identity, because why would he be so strong? And Harbingers are a mixed bag of a bunch of different strong individuals from all across Teyvat. Why not throw a Dragon Sovereign in the mix, especially the Cryo one? Because the Cryo one would have probably the most distaste for Celestia, being that, you know, he aligns with the Tsaritsa perfectly. And all the Dragon Sovereigns aren't the same. Nouvellette is more or less pretty level-headed. He seems to be very caring and not very vicious or malicious. But we know with a pep, most of the dragons don't give a damn about humans, the new world, the Archons, all of that stuff. So it would actually make sense why he's seems to be a lot more conniving, a lot more malicious, kind of like, you know, we were teased with Scaramouche that he's holding Child's family hostage. I think the Rooster would be a lot more ruthless as a Sovereign, being that he's probably got a lot more bitterness to him, kind of like a Pep does, rather than Nouvellette, who's a younger, more level-headed Sovereign that wasn't really around as long, so wouldn't have that distaste and just that bitterness. Now, I can already hear one argument. Well, if he's a Sovereign, he should be ranked higher than 5 if they're ranked by strength. Actually, I think if he's a Sovereign, his 5th ranking is perfect. Because the Captain, Columbina, and Dadore are basically confirmed by Nahida to be on par with Archons or stronger level gods. That's probably their entire role in the Fitui. And Arlecchino is a beast on her own. In fact, Arlecchino sat in a meeting with Nouvellette and Farina, and they were both nervous around her. So the Hydro Sovereign was eerie around Arlecchino, and she was nothing but comfortable. So I think him being, you know, an older, not at full strength Sovereign actually is perfect for number 5, because you're still ranked extremely high. Nahida probably didn't even know his identity, so she probably didn't include him. And if the Rooster is the original Cryo Sovereign, it makes sense why his human form looks a lot older than Nouvellette's, being that Nouvellette isn't the original Joe Sovereign. It's widely debated if the Sovereigns can't quite be killed or erased if they get reincarnated. Like, I'm not sure exactly how that works, but Nibelung, I think we can all agree that he would be connected to the Rooster then in this way, because they're all connected with Khaenri'ah, and I think it's pretty obvious at this point, one way or another, that Nibelung the Dragon King is connected to Khaenri'ah and how they rebelled in some way, or how they got so advanced. And if he is a Descender, or the Third Descender, if they're trying to resurrect him, or if he's just manipulating the Fitui into doing all this, it makes sense that the Cryo Sovereign would be on board and contributing to this, which the Rooster is doing. He plays a very important role in the Fitui, and even recruited some members, including a Harbinger, Tartaglia. And as far as his elf-like appearance, he kind of looks somewhat like Clea Ruka Davada, with his long ears, and he's got the pointy nose. This could be just a pure coincidental design choice. We don't really know for sure if there's some like ancient elven race that was in Genshin or Teyvat long ago, or if this just is a complete design choice, like they give some characters like animal-like features or ears. I'm assuming it's probably just a design choice they went, probably to really mislead us and just deceive us a little bit. But we know for a fact the Rooster will be the main Harbinger and a very important character in Shesnaya's Archon quest, and him being the Cryo Sovereign makes complete sense. And somebody's got to be the Cryo Sovereign. And again, him being the mayor of Shesnaya and running the nation is kind of like Nouvellette being the dragon and being the chief justice in Fontaine. It makes perfect sense. His hidden identity. Why he's so powerful yet doesn't look like it. Why he's sitting on the throne during that trailer while Dainsleif foreshadows the rebellion, even his codename, the Rooster, like we talked about. So that is what I'm proposing. I'm proposing that the Rooster is the Cryo Sovereign, and I do believe him being ranked 5th is perfect. And keep in mind, he's probably not at a full power either, being that the Sovereigns aren't in power. But I think him being ranked 5th is still extremely high, and the top 3 Harbingers are just next level. That's the entire purpose of them. So I do think it actually fits. And like I said, Arlecchino made Nuvolette and Farina very nervous, so I think him being right below her at 5th spot is perfect for the Cryo Sovereign. I think everything aligns with this, but maybe I'm just overthinking it. What do you think? Because hypothetically, let's pretend he is the Cryo Sovereign. The Rooster codename makes perfect sense. Him being in the trailer makes perfect sense. Him running the nation as Shaznai and having Cryo powers as leaked and hinted at makes sense. Him having a human form would make sense. Him having goals that align with the Tsaritsa and the Fatui in general makes sense. Him having such political power and control and being more conniving and malicious would make sense. He doesn't have any love for humans, after all, most dragons don't. Nuvolette is kind of an exception to this, but we don't know for sure. The fact that we're going to meet him in Shaznai and he doesn't seem like the type of Harbinger that we're going to meet just on a whim anywhere else, that makes more sense. The Harbingers all being fairly ancient, powerful beings. Now his rank at 5, that makes sense. Again, I could be overthinking it and this could be wrong, but it's just what I think and just something I thought of the other day, actually, just thinking about the Rooster because he was such an anomaly for me. But again, let me know your thoughts in the comments. Let me know what you think. Does this make sense to you? I really do appreciate y'all watching this far. Please feel free to like and subscribe if you would like to see more like this. It really helps me out. And as always, we will see you all in the next one. Later.